It's October 1st. Today's reading covers several intense confrontations between Jesus and various Jewish leaders. These leaders were angry over Jesus' actions. In fact, they were more angry that their customs had been broken than they were excited that the lame and the sick were healed. In John 5, they were angry that Jesus equated himself with God. He explained that he himself would judge sin, and that he himself will raise the dead through resurrection. These events sent the Pharisees into a rage. And we read in John 5:17 that here, just a few months into his ministry, they're already trying to find a way to kill him. Jesus' contradictions of their Sabbath traditions offers the opportunity to explain that he himself is Lord of the Sabbath. This again made the Pharisees apoplectic. These events revealed the Jewish leaders' hearts. They weren't even open to the possibility that Jesus could be right. Unlike their peer Nicodemus, who genuinely sought to understand Jesus' words, they refused to even consider that Jesus could be right, and that their many preconceived notions could be incorrect. Their hearts were sealed tight around false assumptions. Their minds were closed, and their ways were set. Their perspective was the only one that mattered, and they weren't open to any other way of thinking. Such an attitude is dangerous, yet we see it every day. Many people miss the core message of the gospel because of preconceived notions about various aspects of Christianity that have very little to do with what Jesus taught. Many times people don't want to even consider the words or teachings of Jesus because of preconceived notions like they don't like Christian values, or they think that Christians are hypocrites, or they don't want to give up their fun, or they don't want to join a church, or don't want to get involved in a cult, or they don't want to become religious, or any other number of excuses that have little relation to the reality of the gospel. People must have open hearts in order to receive the message of the gospel. This is why it is critical to be in consistent and ongoing prayer for others. Your prayers matter. They are powerful. You have genuine spiritual authority to assist, enable, restrict, and restrain spiritual forces. Your prayer for others will help to prepare their hearts to hear and their ears to listen. Here's today's application. Do you have a prayer list of people that you pray for consistently? If not, why don't you? Your prayers are powerful. Ask the Lord who you should be praying for. Now here's today's prayer.